Yeah, Smart War Games here. Let's play Yugoslavia, and new DLC for Ostalgie by Kremlin Games. Yeah, text-based political decision game. They already released a couple of them. I'm quite a fan of their game series. The first one was Crisis in the Kremlin, based on this classic DOS game. And yeah, as the name indicates, this is focusing on Yugoslavia and its destiny. So if you select it, you can now choose, yeah, three new countries. So, first I need to check the flags. I think that is Socialist Bosnia, right? And yeah, Croatia and Serbia. And yeah, this game allows you to pursue different goals. Yeah, either you can try and keep Yugoslavia running, yeah, stop it from dissolving. You can pick one of the factions and yeah, work for that goal, but you can also work for independence, you can also work for domination. So let's see, I like diversity on my channel, as when it comes to nations. Croatia would be a nice pick, of course. Serbia, I think also. Croatia, we already had some Croatia focused content, also the Gravity Team expansion. But I think Bosnia, I never played at a Bosnian perspective in any game. I think that is Bosnia, yeah. And yeah, there's a new mode called Battle Yugoslavia. It seems like a war component was added into this game, allowing you to jump right into the, yeah, civil war or into the breakup war of Yugoslavia, without any decision making, any attempt to prevent it, and fight for survival or domination. But we will play the normal game. Yeah, I'm not proficient in the Kremlin games. It is, I also enjoy those games simply riding along, because they are nice educational games with good events, yeah, nice pictures, and of course great music from this era. We could play a bit easier, but I usually like to play the original mode, which allows you to unlock I think replacing leadership, that was a bit too much. And also shifting over to more freedom, plus leadership replacement, that was simply too much. Yeah. Well, what happens if I allow the Democrats, the Social Democrats, to exist? Will this immediate impact on... Do you want to do that? Oh. Yeah, I mean, what... Of course it impacts on them, but not too much. Let's see how it continues. Okay, it was... No, it is fine. It is okay. That is okay. I mean, if the reformers and the Social Democrats exist here in the political system, they might help to do what I try to achieve. Seems even it helped the unity. Helps by having opposition. It helps the unity of your own party. So I will first let that value rise, and then I might conduct some attempts to reform by first replacing politicians. Oh yeah, science. Yeah, people support is important. No, Jimmy, this year. Jimmy, give me those raspberries. We will become the biggest raspberry supplier of the world. Jimmy, what's going on here with my party? +07. Yeah, that was changing those politicians, and that was killing us. That is. Especially while Yugoslavia is running, yeah, you can't pull off some reformers out of your pants. And every impact might lower that. So first, let's wait what happens. Yeah, was first considering that this might rather accelerate the downfall, but there is something to remove you out of your office. Support of the people, minus 1.4, that is not good. I need to build something here. Actually, minus 1.4. Including my money is still going down. What's this? Yeah, I will keep myself out of foreign affairs. To some extent. I think that was the event that nuked me, right? 10 loss in politics. Because I didn't push on that, okay. Well, that's quite a tough choice. I'm back in a second. Yeah, tough choice. I don't know what impact this will have on. I mean, we might start a fight in order to allow for more reforms. Or more reformist mindset. Yeah, we're losing a lot of support by people. Could build an alcohol factory, that might work out. But plus two is very low. TV center would lower our budget. Almost. Yeah, we gain 0.5. We would have to pay 0.2 for maintaining that thing. But if that drops lower and lower, we might. I don't even have money for building anything. So let's roll. I want to stay as long as possible in charge here. But I don't know, support of the people will that trigger the dissolution of Yugoslavia, or yeah, we'll see how it goes. Do nothing and wait for the. Yeah, but currently probably staying passive because of our domestic problems is the best, you know, not to. And it's also always that either this or that. Those strong opinions can sometimes produce consequences. Our fragile let things run their course. Gee, those people will eat us. Perhaps that will give us support by the people. I mean, currently we can, yeah.
Yeah. smo svoji postali.
Let's see, okay, let's start to replace politicians. See how that works out. I mean, we also have a lot of agents. Okay, I gained an alliance with the Social Democrats. Hope this will help. Speech. Why is that? Yeah, might be a good time to do that. Speak about peace in the world.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I think that is a critical event. I think we made it. And I somewhat worked into that direction, so I can show you. So I basically have the goal to go independent. No, damn it. Do I need to pick the first option and then Yugoslavia is dissolving? Hey Beyond, great to have you around. So the DLC came out, what a great game. Yeah, it's very unique game series, I also like it. Less managing a challenge, more about reading those events. A nice history lesson. Also because it is not downplaying those complex politics. And while being in this decision seat, it shows you how difficult it is. I should have perhaps picked the first option and then the entire thing might start it. The first option sounded for me like game over. I mean, it will happen soon anyways, again, because the support of the people is... They're rioting on the streets. There's no way we can... I mean, party support looks good. Might even get my second politician in here. Yeah, let's see how that goes. I hope I'm not being kicked out of the game. I read somewhere that... Okay, yeah, now it happens. Yeah, this is the second time it triggers. Because the situation is already so desperate. Yeah, okay, and what happens now? What I've read, you should now go from basically managing Yugoslavia to managing the country you picked. So in this game, you're basically handling two entities, yeah, Yugoslavia, and you can do what your goals are, as I mentioned, maintain the state of Yugoslavia, get it through the crisis, or make it dissolve, and then strive for goals for the country you picked, which I basically have now, and I have the goal to go for Western alignment. But there's also many other options, yeah, like gaining domination and etc. So, yeah, okay, game continues, and we are, I guess, now in Bosnia-Herzegovina mode, yeah. And we'll see. Good, we are in player control here, what political... Yeah, okay, now it... Yeah, a lot changed here, wait. Yeah, I think we are now in Bosnia-Herzegovina mode. Good, party unity is high. Let's see, we have we are still in alliance with the Social Democrats. I can replace politicians. Yeah, that is definitely Bosnia and Herzegovina politicians. And what is this guy from the Presidium? National Patriot. What is a new Bosnian? Known in the army circles, Patriot. Okay. A leader is currently moderate, right? Okay. Jimmy, what? Why are you? Oh, okay. Effective manager. Communist liberal. Perhaps that's what we want. Should also help with managing the support of the people somewhat. Let's try it out. This will of course destabilize a bit our political system, but that's okay. Okay. Science is still working. Let's see how economy changed. Well, it seems like we have still access. Jimmy, I can still build in Serbia, but yeah, okay, perhaps that is still working. Okay, let's see what happens, yeah. Let's continue and don't overdo it. Perhaps they only removed me from the control. But currently it is calm, yeah. Last time I was removed by the party, and this time we were removed from leadership. Which is fine. So Yugoslavia, I think, is still running. But we are not in charge anymore of them. But we are now in charge of our country. Support of the people, I might need to start to build something before that goes too low. Maybe, but money is too low. Oh, Jimmy, God damn, I need to do budget cuts or what? What is costing us so much money? Minus 0.6, that is crazy. Yeah, I have no access to those buildings anymore. Wait, what happens if I demolish? Is that even? Ah, yeah, I could prioritize stuff. Actually, that might be an idea, prioritize my army bases. But that is perhaps not a good idea. this will give you Vestalgia, but might still provide you with the benefits. Yeah, that might be required, yeah, considering this huge impact here. Okay, prioritize this as well. You can also prioritize the army base, but that is perhaps rather strange. I mean, that is... Let's see what we have else here. Actually, there's quite a lot of money I'm losing here. Might be time to research help from the West. Are we doing that? Okay. But we are still part of Yugoslavia. So now it looks not good for us here. Because I need to wait for some events. But is that only a temporary improvement prioritizing? Yeah, let's see how the events unfold before we prioritize the hang on of our economy. Too many status of Lenin. Prioritize Jimmy, exactly. Are there so many? I think there were, for us, they don't do anything, I noticed. You can build them, which is funny. You can build them, but they do nothing. They do nothing. I know in the main module, if you build them in the DDR or in the Soviet Union, they do something. But here you can build them, they cost only money, yeah, in order to satisfy your Lenin needs. They do nothing. But cost money. Yeah, that would be funny. You prioritize a Lenin's. Yeah. Yeah, Jimmy, man, what the heck is going on here? What is going on in Serbia, man? They have Lenin all over the place. Is it a placeholder or is it Jimmy, prioritize. I can't because I'm not in control anymore of those countries. And we don't have any. But yeah, that is... I don't know, what is the normal bonus of the Lenin statue? Lowering Vestalgia, right? Was it that? I don't know, I can't remember. Yeah, here, that is also... Good, I have a lot of stuff to prioritize, but... This is providing plus one to budget. But I need to compare it to prioritize stuff. Ah, okay, this gives me more budget, okay. But it gives you more Vestalgia as well, yeah, okay, so... If you prioritize our agricultural establishments, we will gain more money, yeah? So let's see how that continues. Otherwise, we need to prioritize the Hegedov and start to get out of here. And build Lenin statues. In every one of my playthroughs, I found prioritizing cause a major death spell for Vestalgia. Yeah, Vestalgia is, if you want to maintain a status quo, Vestalgia is probably the biggest threat. But I wonder how it is, because I'm now currently experimenting with basically going for the West, aligning with the West, become independent, and leave the Yugoslavian or Eastern Sphere. I can't remember how that worked out. I remember when I started this game very early, I also went for a very progressive, reformist, liberal playthrough that was in the Crisis of the Kremlin, but I overdid it. Yeah, I overdid it. If you go too crazy, you will get assassinated or removed from power because you are basically doing it. If you're doing it too fast, too open, that then you will antagonize your entire party and probably also even the people. And currently we are still under the control in Yugoslavia, and also, so I need to wait. Yeah, I wanted to wait for the breakup and then quickly head for the west, if that is even possible. That easily, of course not. Actually, that is not my affair, secondly. Support of the people. Do I need to build? Could build an alcohol factory and privatize it. What this will even get Ostalgie into crazy values. But there's nothing else that provides. Wait, there was another thing that provides. Yeah, but that was a TV center, and that is something I can't absolutely afford. Can't even afford the alcohol factory. So let's see, I could change my politics perhaps somewhat. Let's see. What is a new Bosnian? What is that? Legal Yugoslavian millionaire. Okay. Yeah, hard to tell what this will cause. Because from those values you print on, might need to check the historical profiles of those politicians in order to get an idea of what might happen. Yeah, this could of course help. But I think the war will break out soon, right? No, not really. Is it historically tied, or is it tied to the situation? I need to support the reformers. This might also help with the support of the people. Because those foreign events also have an impact on the support of the people. I guess they're already urging for... what is going on? It's complex. The political. Yeah, this would help nobody. Conduct similar reforms that might help with people, support by the people, and try to reform and our domestic agencies, that they lowered their power, right? Stasi was this, yeah. With reduced powers, exactly. And the Stasi was basically hunting, known for, well, let's say, I guess, disliked by many in the population. So perhaps if we conduct similar reforms, can get the support of the people high. Yeah, perfect. Okay, that will give us some briefing. It's this time pick. Good, we are now in battle mode. Looks like that is still quite similar. Did I pick battle mode? Still here, yeah. We need to talk about if you like the because I need to figure out this battle mode. But yeah, you were right, that is definitely a death switch if that is going red. Wait, something is happening here, I think that is already... What? Okay, I know the collapse is happening. That can also happen in the main game, but here you might accelerate that. If you want to play that. I think now you are choosing. Yeah, so you have even sub-choices based on the country you chose, I think. And yeah, there's already stuff happening that looks very... Okay. That is still controlled by us. That is... Okay, yeah, but it works. Good, here perhaps. Yeah, everything's split up now in parts. Oh, we currently have a truce, okay. But this will change soon. And then you can compare, yeah, this is basically a management game of values, yeah, how much armies you have. You can buy weapons, make peace with nations, try to get out of there. So that is quite a new feature here. Can also pick leadership, which might come with different mindsets and goals. Yeah, but all are now arming. There seems to be a confrontation is now coming up. Guillermo, building electronic factories does a good job balancing Ostalgie and the budget. I found once I had the machine running well, staying power was easy. Yeah, there's usually a formula. I mean, that is absolutely fine. Yeah, those games are not expensive. It is figuring out this formula for whatever you want to achieve. Yeah, different playthroughs. Going with Trotsky in nuclear warfare. That is the only thing I managed successfully. Doing a Trotskyist playthrough. Is going for nuclear warfare in Crisis for the Kremlin, I think, yeah. Okay, the Slovenia has crossed the border. It's Jimmy, slow down. So there is now open warfare. Yeah. Army 0. Army 210. But region defense forces between 1 and 1,300. I guess the army is a maneuver element. And yeah, region defense is simply a static force. Two out of 10. They have definitely a faster growth, but they have currently nothing. But the region defense force, if it is somewhere in the middle between, we might rather now stick with. Let's buy weapons from the enemy. Is there a way to increase intelligence on them? Perhaps we capture that by attacking. Oh, we are at war with them. Yeah, now the war is commencing, yeah. Good, this doesn't look to be a good idea to attack here, especially with keeping in mind that the armies report to be 0 to 126, but the region defense force could topple that. But in order to show you the how that looks, I will simply press on attack, even if it might not work out. Oh yeah, it worked out, okay. That was rather fast. And we have player control 100%. That worked out like a charm, and there was not even a pop-up. Would be of course great to see at least some sort of... Yeah, we managed to capture that. And we control it 100%. That was fast. Good, Slovenia is attacking again. And Serbian and Bosnia and Herzegovina is also now attacking positions. But seems like, ah yeah, okay, player control. He is lower, he is fine. Can now send reinforcements. And increase it back to 100%. Which I guess is some resource you're using. Army over 49. Okay. Good, yeah. It's for me already late, I need to hit the bat. But it shows you how the battle mode works. It wrote success, I attacked him. That's a real success. Okay, now it was a success. But yeah, we're spreading our player army as well. Okay, I did some sort of mini game. Different approach from what you usually have in those games. I have a prof who is Yugoslavian. She seems pretty upset by the whole thing. Seems like it was a bad time. Yeah, that was... yeah, that was... I mean, you mean the wars? Yeah, there was a lot of misery and brutality going on there. No question. Neighbors yesterday, worst enemies, and yeah, some stuff that happened there that is hard to grasp, yeah, and can indeed yeah, as in most wars, yeah, but also it is sometimes hard to grasp what is going on with people, and what they can do to each other is simply beyond belief. Okay, yeah, that was here. The new expansion pack for Ostalgie. Yeah, this is, I also think, a new settings here. You can customize some of the paths. And yeah, I guess also this expansion pack adds new events. Yugoslavian focused events to the normal game if you play another Warsaw Pact nation or at least those nations that are aligned. To the Eastern Bloc. Yeah, she was born in the early 80s, I think. Just old enough to have some of the Ostalgie, but I guess it's easy to have Ostalgie when what came after was so bad. Yeah, it could be. I think I talked once with somebody that there was some good times, that there was some bad times, as many of those states. Yeah, but the war was, of course, a catastrophe, yeah. Yeah, interesting choice, yeah. You can really modify and make a semi-historical game in whatever likings. But you can modify. Yeah, you can modify every country and then run basically the game. Some sort of political simulation. Okay.